I want to offer my thoughts and prayers to the thousands of families whose loved ones were killed in Osama bin Laden's campaign of terror and violence, from the embassy bombings in Africa, to the strike on the USS Cole, to the attacks of September 11, 2001, and so many more. These were not just attacks against Americans, although we suffered grievous losses. These were attacks against the whole world. In London and Madrid, Bali, Istanbul, and many other places, innocent people, most of them Muslims, were targeted in markets and mosques, in subway stations, and on airplanes. Each attack motivated by a violent ideology that holds no value for human life or regard for human dignity. I know that nothing can make up for the loss of the victims or fill the voids they left, but I hope their families can now find some comfort in the fact that justice has been served. Second, I want to join the President in honoring the courage and commitment of the brave men and women who serve our country and have worked tirelessly and relentlessly for more than a decade to track down and bring Osama bin Laden, this terrorist, to justice. From our troops and our intelligence experts to our diplomats and our law enforcement officials, this has been a broad, deep, very impressive effort. Here at the State Department, we have worked to forge a worldwide anti-terror network. We have drawn together the effort and energy of friends, partners, and allies on every continent. Our partnerships, including our close cooperation with Pakistan, have helped put unprecedented pressure on al-Qaida and its leadership. Continued cooperation will be just as important in the days ahead. Because even as we mark this milestone, we should not forget that the battle to stop al-Qaida and its syndicate of terror will not end with the death of bin Laden. Indeed, we must take this opportunity to renew our resolve and redouble our efforts. In Afghanistan, we will continue taking the fight to al-Qaeda and their Taliban allies while working to support the Afghan people as they build a stronger government and begin to take responsibility for their own security. We are implementing the strategy for transition approved by NATO at the summit in Lisbon, and we are supporting an Afghan-led political process that seeks to isolate al-Qaeda and end the insurgency. Our message to the Taliban remains the same, but today it may have even greater resonance. You cannot wait us out. You cannot defeat us, but you can make the choice to abandon al-Qaeda and participate in a peaceful political process. In Pakistan, we are committed to supporting the people and government as they defend their own democracy from violent extremism. Indeed, as the President said, bin Laden had also declared war on Pakistan. He had ordered the killings of many innocent Pakistani men, women, and children. In recent years, the cooperation between our governments, militaries, and law enforcement agencies increased pressure on al-Qaeda and the Taliban.